It is the most important sentence in your essay, so you might want to think about how to make it better. When it comes to argumentative writing, the overall success of the essay is largely a function of how successful your thesis statement is. It can be immensely helpful to have a good draft of your thesis before you even begin writing the essay. This doesn't mean your thesis won't change or evolve as you research and compose, but since a thesis statement is the single most important sentence in an academic essay, especially in a composition class, then it's only logical that you should be crafting it before you even begin writing the rest of the essay. So first things first, let's start with a definition. What exactly is a thesis statement? Well, simply put, it's where the main idea, your main argument, is most clearly stated. It's usually one or two sentences that clue the reader into your particular interpretation of the essay's subject. And especially in academic writing like you're asked to do in a composition class, the thesis statement should pretty much always be the last sentence of your introduction. That might be worth repeating. Again, the thesis statement is one to two sentences, and it's placed at the end of the introduction. A well-crafted thesis statement simultaneously performs three important functions. First, the thesis acts as a kind of roadmap for your overall essay, which makes it easier for readers to follow and gives them an idea of what to expect from your essay. If your thesis mentions ideas or concepts in a certain order, then you need to develop those ideas in the essay body in the same order. If your thesis is something like, "While domesticated house cats all share common features, their personalities can largely be sorted into a few dominant categories, such as alarm clock kitties, furniture-destroying goblins, and sneak attack ninjas," then the reader will expect the body of your essay to be ordered in the same way. If you talk about sneak attack ninja cats first, you cause confusion. Secondly, the thesis statement contains an assertion. It's the sentence where you stake your claim, which means it needs to be an argument or a debatable issue rather than a statement of fact. In academia, you're usually being asked to interpret or connect ideas. The thesis should reflect your position. Remember, what the thesis statement does not do is just state the topic. The subject of an essay might be Moby Dick or the Crimean War or Anish Kapoor and Stuart Semple's art rivalry, but your thesis should offer a way to understand the novel or the war or the rivalry. Third, if you're writing essays for fun, go wild, but in a classroom environment, the thesis statement should most likely address the assignment or the prompt in some way. If an assignment asks you to evaluate recurring themes or metaphors or imagery, then those are the key words you probably want to repeat in your thesis. If your assignment is, say, a rhetorical analysis of an object, your thesis should probably mention rhetoric or elements of rhetoric. By addressing the assignment in your thesis, you're demonstrating that you understand what the assignment is asking you to do. All that being said, here are a few tips for crafting a strong thesis statement. Use subordinating conjunctions to point toward the relationship between ideas. Things like although, as a result, because, since, after, etc. Avoid cliches. Vague and sweeping phrases like since the dawn of time and throughout history don't belong in your essay, but they especially don't belong in your thesis. Avoid vague words that don't help you convey specific ideas. Words like interesting, exciting, unusual, and different don't really pack much punch. Be careful with words that convey abstract ideas. Culture, society, values. These words don't mean much without more information. You need to tell the reader which culture, which society, what kind of values. Avoid making universal statements or oversimplifying an issue. For instance, "We must save the whales" may be true, but it's a dud in terms of a good thesis because it offers no detail or nuance or even your approach. However, if we revise that to "because a sustainable ocean environment depends in part on biological diversity, we should take action to ensure the survival of whales," then we're indicating that we understand how complex the problem is and we're offering an approach to that problem. And lastly, you want to be sure that you state the point of your paper, but you want to do it without writing, "The point of this paper is." That kind of meta-text doesn't really help you make your point. It ends up reading like you're just trying to increase your word count. A strong thesis helps lay the groundwork for a strong essay, which is why it's a good idea to begin drafting the thesis statement before you begin. It also helps to keep it specific rather than vague. The more it really lays out the main idea of your essay, the more work it's doing for you as a writing tool. If you have some key evidence that supports your claim, it makes sense that it would appear in the thesis statement. But don't forget, writing is a recursive process that doesn't just begin at point A and end at point B. Don't be afraid to revise your thesis as you write and develop your ideas. Sometimes we only figure out what we're really trying to say by writing about it and thinking it through.